Hello, and welcome back to another video with It's Dr. Dan, and today we're going to be looking at the hydrogenation of lipids, meaning that whenever we have a really big fat, sometimes you'll have unsaturated fats. So this is something that occurs artificially when you kind of want to buy different things that you find in the grocery store. If you read a lot of those different labels, you'll see that it might say that it's hydrogenated on it. This is a reaction that occurs to help extend the shelf life of a lot of the different things that you commonly find in your grocery store. This also helps create a lot of the different things that we use on a regular basis for baking and things like that. So it transforms the fats, so it gets rid of not having as many unsaturated fats in your diet, but it gets rid of also the possibility of having cholesterol and things like that in those fats as well. So there's kind of like a hit or miss. Like, sure, you have more saturated fats, but this is something that extends shelf life in a lot of your foods. So what it is, just to go through the definition, is hydrogenation is when we take hydrogen gas and we bubble it through a heated oil. So if you have like an oil on your stove, you heat it up really hot, what they do is they bubble hydrogen through it in the presence of a catalyst. Usually this is like usually nickel, for example, being that's usually a little cheaper to use. So when they do this in industry, they will take an unsaturated fat, which is typically a liquid or something that's like a little goopy. And when you add a hydrogen to it, it's going to remove the double bonds and turn them into single bonds. So if you kind of think back to my previous videos on organic, when it came to addition reactions, it's like if we had the double bond, which is like are my two parts of my hand here, and we're going to be opening up that double bond, right? We're opening up the doors. Now, when you're doing that, you're going to be adding hydrogen to each of those little bits, okay? So let's take a look at this reaction and try to see what it's all about. All right, so with the reaction, what we're going to have here is we have an unsaturated fat, and I highlighted the double bonds here in green. And what we're going to be doing is adding hydrogen to them. So like I said before, it's as if we're going to be opening up the double doors. So if I change one of these double bonds to blue here, we're going to be opening it up just like you're opening up a cabinet in your house. So if I were to do that, we're going to open up that double bond on each of these structures. And as a result, we're going to be adding hydrogen to each one, all right? So being that we have our hydrogen under a nickel catalyst right here, this is the idea of the reaction. So, but before we do that, we want to illustrate that this is a complete reaction. So what we're going to do is we're going to copy and paste our structure here, right? And sadly, if you're using a notebook, you got to write it twice. And that's the hardest part, but write them as condensed structures. That makes it a lot easier when doing lipids because geometric is a little long. Remember, these types of molecules are generally 12 to 18 or more carbons long. They're very difficult to always draw, so make it easy on yourself. So what we're going to do is we're going to open up that double bond. So just to illustrate the first one, right, we added hydrogen to each one. Now, what can you generally do instead? Well, you can just write H2 on each of these, just like this, and erase your bond. Now, is this kind of the best way to do that though? This is a condensed structure. So we're adding hydrogen to each, but keep in mind that these structures here are all about, and I realize I forgot some twos here, is that we have a condensed structure, meaning we can use subscripts to minimize these. So what we will do is instead is kind of count how many hydrogens there are. So we're kind of showing our work or in how many carbons you have. So in the middle here, we have one, two carbons, and then another set of CH2. So we have seven of them next to it. So we have a total of nine CH2s that are going to make. Over on our left-hand side, we also have seven CH2s, so we'll add them all together. So if we kind of count, right, we have seven plus seven plus two, so that's 16 total. So what we are going to do is kind of erase this all here in the middle. And we are going to make it so that our CH2s will now say 16, because we're counting all of our carbons. And then we'll move over our CH3s. So this would be our final answer down here. So notice how by hydrogenating it, it all gets nice and clumped together as one little nice little solid is kind of how I like to think about that, right? Because when it's saturated, this is going to be a solid as a result. Okay, so we have a saturated fat. So those are all single bonds. Versus when we started, right, there were double bonds or unsaturated fat. And that's the whole idea, is that you're opening up those double bonds. And now this can be done not just with hydrogenation. It can be done with bromination, hydrohalogenation. Any of the addition reactions can be done with this. And if you need a little fresh refresher on addition reactions, go refer back to my video on addition reactions too. I hope that this video helped. It was short and sweet and to the point. And if you want to see future videos, please like, subscribe, comment, let me know what you think, and I'd be happy to make more. All right, I'll see you all later, and I hope you all have a wonderful day. Bye now.